We can implement a list in our program using either arrays or linked lists. Arrays are statically allocated lists, which means that their size is fixed at compile time. We cannot increase or decrease the size of an array at runtime. While these linked lists are dynamically allocated lists, which means that we can vary the size of a linked list at runtime. Now in arrays, if the amount of data that is to be stored at runtime is less than the size of array, then there is wastage of memory, while if the data that is to be stored at runtime is greater than the size of array, then we have an overflow condition, and in that case, the program does not work properly. In linked list, we don't have any such problem because the size of a linked list can vary at runtime. So we can insert new elements till memory is available. Now we learn about single linked list, which is the simplest form of a linked list. A single linked list is made up of nodes, and this is the structure of a node of a linked list. It has two parts. The info part contains the actual data that is to be stored in the list, and this link part is used to point to the next node of the list. That is, it contains the address of the next node of the list. Now this is how a single linked list looks like. The info part of each node contains the actual data. Here the data is only an integer value. It can be of some other type also. And the link part is pointing to the next node of the list. So the link part of this node contains the address of this node. Link part of this node contains address of this node. Link part of this node contains address of this node. Now this is the last node of the list. So it has no next node to point to. So the link part of this node is null. The address of the first node is stored in a special pointer. We have named it start, and all the elements of this list can be accessed with the help of this pointer only. Now if we compare our linked list with an array, we can see that the nodes of a linked list are not stored in contiguous memory locations, while the elements of an array are stored in contiguous memory locations. This is because the whole array is allocated once at compile time, while nodes of linked list are allocated at different times during runtime. Now let us see how we can implement a single linked list in our program. We'll take a self-referential structure to represent the node of a single linked list. A self-referential structure is a structure where we have a pointer member that can point to the structure of the same type. So this pointer member link here is of type struct node, and it can point to a structure of type struct node. This pointer member is used to point to the next node of the list. So it will contain the address of the next node of the list. And this is the info part. Here is an example where the info part contains only an integer value, and this is the link part. This is another example. Here the info part contains three members. This is another example where the info part is a structure. In our examples, we'll take this structure where the info part contains only an integer value. Now to implement a linked list, the first thing that we'll have to do is declare a pointer start and initialize it to null. So this will indicate that the list is initially empty. Now let us have a look at the program of single linked list. This is a structure of a node of our single linked list. We have taken only an integer value in the info part. Now in main, the first thing that we have done is take a pointer start and initialize it to null. So this indicates that the list is initially empty. After this, we have created the list using this function createList. Now in this while loop, we are performing various operations on the list depending upon the choice that is entered. These operations are displaying the contents of the list, counting the number of nodes in the list, searching for an element in the list, inserting a new node in the beginning of the list, inserting a new node at the end of the list, inserting a new node after a specified node, inserting a new node before a specified node, inserting a new node at a particular position, deleting a node from the list, and reversing the list. So in the next few lectures, we'll see how to write definitions of all these functions.